it's game four. Houston leading 2-1. And every time the Dodgers have had to win a game, they have gone to this man, Fernando Valenzuela. He's been their most consistent pitcher, and he's done it with the screwball you just saw right there. Vern Rule for Houston, Valenzuela for the Dodgers. Is he worried? He'll answer that for you right now. Sports presents the National League Division Series. Tonight from Dodger Stadium, the Houston Astros against the Los Angeles Dodgers. The National League Division Series is brought to you by Löwenbräu. When you want the taste of a truly great beer, there's really only one. Tonight, let it be Löwenbräu. By Ford and your Ford dealer, who invite you to test drive the 1982 Ford cars and trucks. And by Polaroid, makers of the exciting Time Zero One Step. Now more than ever, Polaroid means fun. And by Sears Roebuck and Company, you can count on Sears. Los Angeles, California. You're looking outside the ballpark. You can see the parking lot fairly well full, still coming in. Inside, they expect every seat to be taken. They expect a sellout for this game number four. Hi, everybody. I'm Joe Garagiola, and it will be Vern Rule for Houston, Fernando Valenzuela for the Dodgers. He is their most consistent pitcher, 13-7. Earned run average, 2.48, but he's 4-3 in the second half. But here in Los Angeles, they put all that aside. It's an incredible hype when he pitches. It's Fernando Mania. You want a commemorative coin? You can buy it. You want a button? Here it is. You need a postcard? Here's another one. You want a poster? Got a poster. Newspaper? He's on the cover. You buy a scorecard? Well, I got him upside down. He's everywhere. You need a t-shirt? I got a t-shirt. What a hype. But Tony, when he gets on the mound, he's got a pitch.
Joe, you know, there's one thing about these Astros. They're looking at one number concerning Fernando Valenzuela, the seven losses tacked behind his name. They do not feel he's invincible. The star on the other side of the field, somewhat unknown, Vern Rule. Several years ago, he was released by the Detroit Tigers. Everyone but Rule thought his career was over. After that, he had severe back surgery. Once again, everyone but Vern Rule felt his career was over. This year, his numbers are not very impressive. He had a lengthy stay on the disabled list. I think his pitching coach, Joe Mel Wright, summed him up best and is not faint praise. He said, of all the pitchers on our staff, he probably knows how to pitch better than anybody. So his stats are not very impressive, but he was 12-4 last season.
Well, we'll find out. Rule against Valenzuela, hype and all. It should be quite a night here at Dodger Stadium. We'll be right back.
Good afternoon. This is Cesar Cedeno, and I will be giving you the lineup today. Leading off is a guy that really carried us in the playoff last year. Good outfielder. His name is Terry Poole, leading off for Astros. Batting second, my kind of players, Phil Gardner, tremendous guy to run the second bag. Playing in center field today will be Tony Scott, a guy that was a tremendous asset to the Astros in the second half. Batting cleanup will be the Super Puerto Rican, which we call Mikey Mal, Jose Cruz. Hitting fifth, playing on first base, will be myself, truly. Hitting sixth will be Al Howe, a guy that really carried the ball club in this second half. He's had an outstanding year and still swinging about great. Al Howe playing at third base, hitting sixth. Batting seventh from Puerto Rico, a guy that had really helped us in the second half also, Dickie Thorne. Batting eighth, another of my homies from the Dominican Republic, Luis Pujol, a guy with good arm, tremendous catcher, good future. And today, pitching for the Astros will be a guy that doesn't have an overpowering fastball, but he knows how to move the ball around and should give the Dodgers a hard time. Vernon Rule will be our starting pitcher for today.
Fernando Valenzuela. He should get a tremendous hand. Here they come. Thank you. Cedeno did a good job with the lineup, Tony. You personally picked him.
Well, Fernando Valenzuela, who's in your picture right now, speaks very little English. He is trying to learn. 10 years ago, when Cedeno joined the Houston Astros, he did not speak a word of English, and you see how far he has come. The man out there, just 20 years old, and everybody asks the question as we watch him from four different angles on Harry Coyle's quad split. They asked, does the pressure bother him? Well, 6 months ago, yesterday, he was called to start the opening ball game in here in Dodger Stadium. Jerry Royce was scheduled to start, came up with a pulled hamstring. Valenzuela had pitched batting practice the day before. What did he do? He shut out the Astros.
It was interesting watching him warm up, Tony, that he didn't really go up looking as high as he usually does and shut his eyes, that upper right-hand corner shot. He still isn't doing that, which is one of his trademarks. Valenzuela led the league in innings pitched with 192. He had 180 strikeouts. Complete games, he led the league with 11. Led the league in shutouts with 8. There are his statistics for the year. 200-plus innings pitched, 146 hits. Strikeouts, an amazing ratio to the base on balls.
Two things the Astros are going to try and do tonight against Valenzuela. They may try and punt. They feel they can beat him to his right with Guerrero at third base. If they get on, they will challenge his move and try and steal as they did in game number one.
And Terry Poole will lead it off. He's a first ball fastball hitter. Will bunt at any time. He's hitting 231 in this series. 3 base hits, 13 times at bat. Guerrero is in close. Strike one. Outside, ball one. You would think that Valenzuela would pitch towards the, with his foot on the first base side of that rubber, Tony, but he's on the third base side with the left-hand hitter. Didn't mean to swing. It is a fair ball. They got him.
The advantage Valenzuela has will be to right-handed hitters pitching from the third base side because the screwball will have a better angle at the outside corner against right-handed hitters.
Phil Garner.
Here is Garner. Garner hitting at an even 200. 2-for-10. Poole tried to check his swing. Ball hit his bat. Socia got out of the box in good shape. Guerrero is in close at third once again. Foul ball. Strike one.
These two teams' batting averages going into game number four are a composite right around 200. Garvey's hitting over 300 and Jose Cruz 300. We'll watch the positioning of Valenzuela's foot on the third base side of the rubber. Bobby Castillo, another one of the pitchers for the Dodgers, helped him tremendously in the Instructional League 1 year.
One ball and one strike. Tony hears so much about pitchers pushing off the rubber, he doesn't even use it. As we saw in that shot, he stands there, and as he gets set, he's just barely in contact with it. It's a strike. One ball, two strikes.
You just saw the pitch that makes Valenzuela. All the hype on his screwball, and it is a good one with a change of speeds, but his ability to spot that fastball, and he can bust a guy inside right now.
Outside corner, first strikeout for Valenzuela, and you saw a good shot at how he sets himself before he delivers as far as his positioning.
You may also have seen by those two called fastball strikes taken by Garner, the Astros thinking gets him. Look for the screwball and give him the fastball.
And that'll get him his quarter of strikeouts. In 1981, he averaged 8.4 strikeouts per 9 innings. There's another one. Here is Tony Scott. Hitting at 154, 2-for-13, 1 RBI. He gets his crowd up early. They announced a sellout. We still see some empty seats, but I would imagine that they'll be filled by the time this game is in about the third inning. Struck him out. 1, 2, 3. He's getting a standing ovation from the people behind third. So we go into the bottom half of the first inning. Houston nothing. Dodgers coming to bat. Beautiful California sky. What a setting here in Dodger Stadium as we look at the skyline of Los Angeles. Game four. Houston with Vern Rule on the mound. And here's the lineup he'll be facing. Davey Lopes leads it off at second base. Kenny Landreau in center field. Batting third, Dusty Baker in left field. Steve Garvey's the first baseman. Monday is in right field. Guerrero at third base. Batting seventh, Socha the catcher. Bill Russell the shortstop. Batting eighth, and Valenzuela bats ninth. And Tony, this Vern Rule, 4-6 is his record, but a 2.91 earned run average.
Well, he does not have one outstanding pitch, but he has four pitches, all very good. If he has control, he can get over any time he wants. A good straight change, a sinker ball, a slider, a curve ball. He will go to off-speed stuff many times. And he does pitch a lot better on dirt and grass than an artificial surface. Because he's primarily a low-ball pitcher, the balls do not get through the infield as quickly.
And he doesn't walk many. You'll have to go out and beat him. Here's Davey Lopes, who's been known to jump on that first pitch. I doubt if it'll be a fastball. Hitting at 250 with three base hits, 12 times at bat. Curveball, strike one.
Pujols, a little bit of a surprise starter. You might recall it was Ashby who started in game one against Valenzuela. Verdon may feel that from the right side. The power comes into play more to left field in this ballpark.
Outside, one ball, one strike. Earn Rule, there's his record. 4-6, but a good earned run average. Outside, two balls and a strike.
Joe, that 12-4 record that Rule had last season, and I don't think many people realize this, was the best winning percentage of any Astro starter last year.
Dickey Thon, long throw, Davey Lopes is out. Astros signed Rule as a free agent in 1978 after being released by the Tigers during spring training. Here is Kenny Landreau. Landreau, 3-for-12, one run batted in, that's a 250 batting average.
The impressive stat on Rule right there was his 29 bases on balls. You had better hit your way on up this man.
He'll make you work. Averages 1.8 walks per nine innings. Outside, ball one. Ball game just underway. Valenzuela worked a perfect one inning, top of the first, two strikeouts. Pull foul, one ball, one strike. And there he is, Fernando. And this whole town caught up in this Fernando mania. After they won the game yesterday, they were lined up, and I took a personal poll and asked people about would they be coming and buy tickets if Fernando wasn't pitching. Some of them said I would buy them, but I wouldn't wait this long if somebody else was pitching. So he has really packed them in. Landreau has hit Rule well, 4-for-7 with a home run, a 571 average. Hard hit. Garner has it. And there are two outs.
When Mal Wright talked about Rule knowing how to pitch better than anybody else, that's what he means. You'll go back to the bench. Now, two balls have been hit hard, but because Vern Rule can put the ball where he wants to, his defense can set up properly in the infield. So the ball's hit hard, but right at the two infielders.
Dusty Baker. There you see it, 3-for-12, one RBI, a 250 batting average in this series. He hit a double yesterday. He got it going. Lopes was on at first. Sacrificed the second by Landreau, and Baker doubled him in. Then Garvey hit the home run, and the Dodgers had three runs on the scoreboard in the first inning. To him, watching you, Bill, we can't tell if you're two runs behind or four ahead. He said, when have I ever been four ahead? Curveball,
It's a strike. There's Lasorda in one of his more quiet moments. High. One ball and one strike. Nobody on. Two men out. Vern Rule. What a story. Underwent back surgery for the removal of a disc. Came back. Curveball gets the corner. One ball, two strikes.
Till this point, and hasn't faced that many Dodger hitters, it appears that Rule is just showing them the fastball and making them hit either the slider, the curveball. He's not yet thrown a straight change.
1-2 pitch. Right side. Cedeno will give it to Rule. He does. And so it's 1-2-3 for the Dodgers in the bottom of the first. We complete one inning here. Houston nothing, and the Dodgers nothing.
Dodger catcher Mike Socha has developed a tremendous rapport with Valenzuela. We asked him what makes Valenzuela so tough to hit.
I believe everybody's familiar with his screwball, and they give a lot of credit to it, his screwball, but he also has four other pitches that he'll throw. Change speeds on a screwball along with a fastball, a curveball, and a slider. I think when he spots his fastball, that sets up all his other pitches that he'll throw anytime in a count. So hitters really can't sit on one pitch or sit on one speed of a pitch. They have to realize he does have five pitches and he'll use them all at any time.
Spoken like a true catcher. He'll use them all at any time. And he has, and that's why he has the record that he has. Valenzuela, as Cruz takes it inside, and it's two balls and one strike. Cruz is hitting 308, 4 for 13, one RBI, one double.
And what Socha said, what that means to a hitter, is very simple. You might face Valenzuela four times in a ball game and never see the same pitch twice.
Two balls and a strike. Strike is called a good fastball. 6 months and one day ago, Valenzuela shut out the Astros, as you heard Tony mention. It was opening day. Just missed outside. They thought they had it.
And Joe, the fact that Socha has a knowledge of the Spanish language does not hurt him in his rapport and conferences on the mound with Valenzuela.
Three-two pitch. Well hit left field. Baker near the line had him played perfectly, and there's one out. Here's the famous trademark now, Valenzuela, as he seems to look away from the hitter and go one-on-one. There he goes, looking straight up. Give me all the help you can give me.
Joe, you wonder if as a kid in Mexico, Valenzuela did not see Louis Tion pitch, because Tion pitched down in the Mexican League and had a little bit of the same mannerisms.
Tion did all kinds of things. I always believed that, I don't care where you sat in the park, there was one time during the delivery he was looking right at you. There's a strike. Cesar Cedeno hitting at 182, 2 for 11. He has two stolen bases. Fastball, strike two.
We continue to give him the fastball and look for the off-speed stuff. And Socha is working that fastball just beautifully on the corners.
Fernando struck out Garner and Scott in the first inning. Cruz hit the ball hard. Here's the two-strike pitch. High hopper. Bill Russell at short has it. Two outs.
Cedeno on this hopper to Russell. You will see he's running a lot better. Recall last year in postseason play that Cedeno dislocated his ankle. Severe surgery. It really meant that he was moved to first base and out of the outfield, but his speed is beginning to come back almost a year later.
That brings up Art Howe. Dickie Thon, the on-deck batter. The outfield straight away in center field, but look at Rick Monday in right field as they give him right center field. He's kind of guarding the line. There's the gap. Howe can go to right field, but they don't think that he'll go to the gap. It's a strike. Howe's hitting at an even 200, 2 for 10. He has one home run. And of course, one RBI. Way outside. One ball and one strike.
Hal said before the ball game, while Valenzuela, I am giving him the fastball. I know I will get at least one screwball each time at bat. He said, Fernando also remembers I beat him the ball game off an inside fastball earlier this year.
There's the screwball. It went outside. Two balls and a strike. Top half of the second inning. No score. Game four. Turned it over, took something off, changed speeds, and it's two balls and two strikes. Warren Spahn said pitching is simply keeping the hitter off balance. Valenzuela does that so well. Just fought it off. Lopes has it in time. So it's three up, three down for Houston in the second. Valenzuela's retired six in a row. We go to the bottom of the second. Houston nothing, Dodgers nothing, and it'll be Garvey, Monday, and Guerrero for Los Angeles. From somewhere outside Dodger Stadium, Roger Harbaugh's got some shot. He must be up in a tree somewhere. The lights are on here. Steve Garvey steps in, hits the first pitch. Dickey Thon, his shortstop, has it, and Garvey is out.
Four ground ball outs now for Bert Rule.
Number 16.
And he pitched him inside and low. Dickey Thon played Garvey in the hole. Made him hit it there.
I love that name, Dickey Thon. Sounds like the line from a Cajun song or something. Dickey Thon. No?
No.
Okay. He came over from the California Angels, and Bill Burden, very high on that young man. Born in South Bend, Puerto Rico now.
Val Burden has used three different shortstops in four ball games. He started with Garcia, played Thon, he has started Reynolds. Back to Thon again.
Here's Rick Monday hitting 222, two for nine. It's the first pitch deep to left field. Cruz going over, running hard. He's there. Nice running catch.
Joe, this is not the time of day that it is easy to pick a ball up. It's kind of half daylight, half dark. It may get even worse. But that ball gets up there above the lights, as this one did. An exceptional play by Cruz. He has worked so hard defensively because he took a lot of knocks. The lack of light at this point did not fool him at all. Went straight on a beeline, right to the ball, right to the wall.
He was way over in left center, Tony. He covered a lot of ground.
There's a lot of speed in that outfield.
So two pitches, two outs. Here is Guerrero hitting at 182. Two for 11 with a double. It's a strike. We are in the bottom of the second. There is no score. Strike two, Vern Rule, moving the ball in and out.
Manny Mota talks about Guerrero. He still feels, and he is still very young, early 20s, Guerrero. He will be one of the best hitters in the game. He is so strong. The only problem Mota says he will have is if he does what he tried to do on the last pitch, pull the outside pitch. He is strong in the alley.
High, ball one, and there is Manny Mota. He is coaching at first base. Back. Third base coach is Danny Ozark. Pitching coaches, you've heard him talk about him. Ron Paranoski, Sandy Koufax was in the park again today.
Monty Basgall, another one of the coaches, who does an excellent job not only teaching middle infielders, but also positioning them.
Art Howe at third base has it. The throw in time. So it's three up and three down. So at the end of two innings to score here, it's the Astros nothing, the Dodgers nothing. What would you pay to see that picture? We'll be back after these messages from your local station. You're looking at the official Houston Astros box. Man on the right, the gentleman, John McMullen, the owner, and to his left, or to his right and our left, Al Rosen, who's the general manager.
He made a couple pretty good moves. that really did a facelift on this Astros team for the second half, getting Rodney Scott and Phil Garner. Tony Scott, excuse me.
They were good moves. There's the strike. Dickie Thon, 2-for-5, a .400 batting average. In the game he played, it was his glove that really stood out. Strike two. John McSherry is behind the plate as we look at Louis Pujols in the on-deck circle. Pull foul.
Both pitchers thus far able to get the ground ball. Neither has allowed a hit. 8 of the 12 outs have been in the infield. Well, he led the league in a few categories. Strikeouts number one.
Outside. One ball, two strikes. Nobody out, nobody on. Both pitchers have retired 6 men in a row. Outside. Two balls and two strikes.
Many people wonder how Valenzuela can have the kind of poise he does and presence on the mound at just 20 years of age. At age 12 in Mexico, he played in the toughest semi-pro league as an outfielder first baseman.
This one's popped up in foul territory. Garvey has room. One out.
Garvey, number 6, catcher, Luis Pujols.
Luis Pujols is the batter with one out. The National League batted only .205 against Valenzuela this season. Pujols 0-for-3 so far in this series. A hard worker.
Deacon Jones has really improved his swing.
He's got him hitting those fungos with just to throw the ball up with the left hand so he can get that front hand and front arm into the ball. Took something off. He is way out in front. Strike one. And there's Deacon Jones. Bill Burton.
A little piece of trivia involved with Deacon Jones. We'll shoot an option in a while that very few people know.
Foul out of play. Strike two.
If we were to ask you the question, who is the first black player to be in any part of baseball's Hall of Fame, people would say Satchel Paige, I'm sure, or others. Well, Deacon Jones was American Legion Player of the Year one year, and his name went in the Hall of Fame.
Fernando. Bouncing ball. Guerrero backs up. Long throw. He's got a good arm. Two outs. 8 men in a row for Valenzuela.
Guerrero started as a third baseman, moved to the outfield. He's played some second base. He has not really been tested thus far in this series. In fact, there have been very few balls hit hard to anybody in this series, except for a few home runs. Pujols way out in front. Guerrero, to prevent getting the in-between hop, backs up, which is not always advisable, but with a slow-moving runner, you can do it.
Here is Vern Rue, pretty good hitter. 6-for-24 this season. Strike. Valenzuela has struck out 2. He's retired 8 in a row. Strike 2. Well, the Phillies tied it up. Milwaukee tied it up. He struck him out. So it's a third strikeout. 9 men in a row for Valenzuela. We go to the bottom of the third. Houston nothing. Dodgers nothing. Coming up, it'll be Socha, Russell, and Valenzuela.
The life of the lonely cameraman, Roger Harbaugh and Rory O'Connor, way out there.
You can see those Cowboys coming over the hill, can't you?
Beautiful shot. Dodger Stadium. There's where they are. That's Roger's shot. Socha, 1-for-7, 143 in this series. Rule checking with his first baseman.
He's trying to move Cedeno, I believe. He is moving him deeper. Cedeno refuses to go, and Cedeno said, I'll get a ball, and I'll get the first. Don't worry about it.
That always bothers me when infielders do that, because the pitcher should have the last say. Bunnett, Rule can't make it. Will Howe, yes, he does. Nice play by Art Howe.
A surprise bunt by Socha. He has not done that too often this season, but he thought he had Howe back. When he got the ball by Rule, it looked like it was all over, and a very fine play by Art Howe. Here it is again. Howe diagnosed the play when he saw the top hand slide up Socha's back. Off balance, excellent throw.
It's a do-or-die play. You try to make the bare hand a pickup. And they practiced that play in spring training as we look at Bill Russell. He's 1-for-9 in this series. It's a 111 average. Third baseman will place about 8 balls halfway between home plate and third base in spring training and come charging in, pick one up and throw it, pick one up and throw it. Curveball, 1-1 on Russell. Valenzuela's the on-deck batter. He should get quite a greeting from this crowd. High fly ball, left field. Cruz, 2 outs, and here comes Fernando. Let's see what happens when they announce it.
34, fetcher, Fernando Valenzuela.
Out of the 11 games, he's worked sellouts. Pitching with 3 days rest, that's quite a graphic.
He's a Rookie of the Year candidate, a Cy Young Award candidate, and I'm sure he'll get some votes for MVP.
And not a bad hitter. Takes it inside, ball one. During the year, he went to bat 64 times, had 16 base hits, which averages out to 250. Vern Rule off the mound will take it himself. He does. And Vern Rule retires 9 men in a row. We complete 3 innings. Houston nothing. Dodgers nothing as both pitchers have retired 9 men in a row. We got a dandy going here in Dodger Stadium. We've heard about Fernando Mania. I asked his manager, Lasorda, what is a Fernando Valenzuela?
Joe, he's the most relaxed young man I've ever seen in all the years I've been in baseball. You know, I've thought about it many times. You know, I think maybe he's an old Mexican general many, many years ago who was up in heaven. And Mr. O'Malley, who was up there with him, decided that we needed help down here. And he sent this guy down to do a tremendous job for us. He's just an amazing young man. And to see the way he relaxes and has fun in the dugout and the clubhouse with all the guys and can't speak any English. He has a good time with the players and doesn't say one word of English. I'll tell you something. He's just special to all of us.
His manager trying to describe him as we look at the amazing young man. Here is Terry Poole. He tried to check his swing the first time up, tapped in front of the plate, and was an easy out. Socha to Garvey.
That
slow, ball one.
That may be the first hitter that Valenzuela has faced, and I do not have an official count, that he has not thrown a strike on the first pitch.
It's amazing that he's ball one and you think about him being behind the hitter. Ball two. Now he's behind him. This I know he hasn't reached. This is the first hitter he's gone 2-0 on.
Neither team with a base hit. A lot of ground balls thrown up by both pitchers, Valenzuela and Rule, to this point.
Straight away center field. Landro has the beat on. It should be an easy out. So there's one away, and let's pause briefly for our station identification. This is the NBC Television
Bill
Network.
Garner, second base.
Nothing, nothing. Valenzuela against Vern Rule. Houston against Los Angeles. One out here in the fourth. Garner the batter. Game four. The Oakland A's, they've won their battle with Kansas City. Milwaukee and the Yankees are tied up. Phillies and Montreal tied up. What a ball game. Vukovich, those Phillies. It's like a repeat of last year, as Dick Enberg mentioned. And the Dodgers are hoping of a repeat of last year, what they did the last 3 days. Garner fouls it off. Remember that battle.
And if there will be a game five tomorrow for the National League's Western Division Championship, it'll be another magnificent pitching matchup. Jerry Royce versus Nolan Ryan. 4 o'clock Eastern time. There is Scott on deck.
Popped up in the infield, and Guerrero makes the play. Two outs.
Joe Valenzuela signed his first professional contract with the Mexican League team at 15 years of age. And too often, the people who dig these players out, beat the bushes, the scouts, do not get a whole lot of credit. Mike Brito. Several other teams were interested in him. Some didn't come up with the money.
Here is Tony Scott. Strike one. I guarantee you, when he signs his next contract, there are going to be enough guys around here. It's going to look like the Declaration of Independence. Everybody's representing Valenzuela now. Scott was out on strikes his first time up. 11 men in a row retired by Valenzuela. Fouled off. Strike two. Both clubs confident. Astros say we just have to win one. Dodgers, Steve Howe, he said it's just a one-game series. We have to win it every day. Struck him out. That's the fourth strikeout. He's retired 12 men in a row. So we go to the bottom of the fourth inning. Houston nothing. Dodgers nothing. We'll join Brian Gumbel tomorrow, NFL 81. All the highlights, the scores, the late-breaking news from all the games. Then you'll have some regional action and some pretty good ones. Browns against the Steelers, Raiders against the Chiefs in Kansas City. So check your local listings for the game and time in your area. That's tomorrow, NFL 81, and definitely the Phillies-Montreal Expo game, and possibly this one. Popped up near the stand. Cedeno giving chase. It's out of play. Phillies and Montreal are tied, two games apiece, so they'll be playing game number five. And depending on the outcome of this one, and right now, it's nothing, nothing. Valenzuela's retired 12. Rule has retired 9 in a row.
Rule has gotten 7 of his nine outs and ground balls. Little pine tie rag, Davey Lopes. He may have hurt that hand, Joe, with that swing. That's what he's going back. He's trying to give that hand a little rest, right wrist. Injured earlier this year, re-injured it when he dove back into the bag in the Astrodome.
There's Joe Beckwith. Next to Valenzuela, the crowd hooping it up, except for the lady in the middle. She's an Astros fan. Inside. One ball and one strike. Off the end of the bat. One ball, two strikes.
In a ball game like this, I guess if it stays this close late in the ball game, if one or the other team has an advantage, you might say it's the Dodgers because they have a few more hitters who can hit the ball out of the ballpark. But to this point, Rule has given them absolutely nothing they can get in the air and hit with authority.
Bouncing ball. Garner at second base. Tricky hop. He gets a nice play by Phil Garner. That was not an easy play.
This is a very hard infield. They did water it down for several hours, and even at that, the ball almost bounded over the head of Garner, but he kept his eye on the ball right into his glove. Bill Verdon talks about Garner as the man who has solidified his infield, and he says, if we do have a leader on the field, he's my man, the first I've had since I've been here as a manager. He's talking about Garner.
One out in the fourth. 10 men in a row retired by Vern Rule. Here's Kenny Landreau. He bounced out to Garner his first time up. Garner once again. Another ground ball, two up and two down. Both these pitchers in command at this point.
9 of 11, Dodger outs, ground balls. Pitching has been so dominant in as many championship series in both leagues. A lot of people theorize why. I think the best I've heard came from Don Leppard. Astros coach, he said, you know, the pitchers had those 2 months off during the strike. Pitchers are coming in now with 150 innings pitched. Like last year, Carlton went to the World Series. He had over 300 innings pitched. Pitchers just have not tired out. They don't have as many innings under their belt.
Straight away center field. Well hit, but Scott's there. So it's three up, three down. Easy inning for Rule. Like Valenzuela threw four innings. He's retired them in order. 12 men in a row. End of four, nothing, nothing. Astros and Dodgers will be right back after these messages from your local station.
Joe Garagiola, Tony Kubek back at Dodger Stadium. For each pitcher through four innings has retired 12 hitters. Valenzuela will face Jose Cruz, Cesar Cedeno, and Art Howe. No score in the ball game.
Jose Cruz.
Neither team has a hit. Neither team has committed an error. Cruz, the last time up, tried to go to left field on Valenzuela. Fly to Dusty Baker.
Baker again guarding that line, playing him like he were a right-handed pull hitter in left field.
There is a huge gap in left center field for Cheo Cruz. Now Landro is moving over a little bit more toward left to cut down the gap. Valenzuela pulls the string, one strike. He has really been ahead of the hitters. There is the defensive alignment. You can see Russell at short. Playing about straight away. The big gap is down the right field line. Should Cruz pull it, Mundy will have a long run into the corner. One strike. Breaking pitch. Curve or slider, 0-2.
Cruz doesn't seem to have the authority with that swing. Just fooled with it. It was out of the strike zone, but Valenzuela, he's just been tough.
Valenzuela misses with a fastball, one ball, two strikes. Cruz with 13 home runs this year, but 10 of them have been hit on the road. Show you how spacious the Astrodome is. 1-2 with nobody out. Screwball to the left-handed hitter Cruz. Count goes 2-2. No score in the ballgame. Home plate umpire John McSherry. There has been all but no quibbling with the umpire's calls in this series. Slider hangs high. Valenzuela goes 3-2. Fernando has struck out four. Rule has not yet struck out a Dodger. 3-2. Fastball got in on it. Socha. One out, 13 in a row for Valenzuela.
Young catchers, just watch this. Socha sees it go up. He finds the ball. Now watch what he does with his mask. Throws it behind him so he'll not stumble on it. Make sure that he has it, and then just lets it fall into that big mitt.
Now Valenzuela will face Cesar Cedeno, who grounded to short in the second. This season, although Cedeno has not faced Valenzuela that often, he is 4-for-10. If I recall, he stole two bases on Valenzuela. Game one at the Astrodome. He also made what could have been a costly play when he ran through Leppard signed at third. Screwball, did he go? Peel goes down to the first base umpire. Lee Wire, he said he did. One strike.
We'll give you a chance to call it. What do you think?
You bet.
Oh, yeah.
One strike, one out, no score in the ball game.
Tell you one thing, I wouldn't argue with Wire or McSherry.
Screwball, that's a hard screwball. He goes 0-2 very quickly to Cedeno. Valenzuela does not simply have two speeds on his screwball. That was the hard one. Just tails away. He throws one that goes down. he may have 5-6 different speeds. He tried to sneak a ball in on him. The first base hit of the ball game off Valenzuela, off the bat of Cedeño. So with one out, you've got to expect Cedeño, as he did in game one, to try and steal second base. Howe, an excellent hit and run man, hits Valenzuela the opposite field very well.
He got that pitch in on him. He was going to jam him. He didn't really drive it hard, but got just enough of the bat on the ball to get the base hit. First base hit, and pretty obvious the first base runner, and we may see some action.
So Valenzuela, streak stops at 13 consecutive retired. Rule still has his no-hitter. He has retired 12 in a row. Art Howe. Bob Lillis, the first base coach, when I asked what the base stealers will be looking off in Valenzuela, he said his right hip. When he closes his right hip, he's going to first. When he doesn't close it, he had Cedeño going back. That high leg kick, in fact, that's what Lillis said. He said, we've got to prevent our potential base stealers from watching the head. There's Lillis, a former Dodger, watching his head and his foot. Concentrate on the front hip. Cedeño that time obviously was not. One ball, no strikes, one out. No score in the ball game. We're in the top of the fifth. Howe grounded to second base in the second inning. It's a gap between Lopes and Garvey. Cedeño with a good lead. May have had an idea. Most difficult thing they've had with Valenzuela is trying to vary his pattern. He is still so young, they don't want to ruin his motion toward home plate. See that Valenzuela move from first base, Joe?
That's not his good move, though. He's just kind of letting them know that I know you're there.
One ball, no strikes to Art Howe. One and one. Howe trying to give Cedeño a chance. Should he want to run? First base umpire Lee Wire watching the moves very closely as to where Valenzuela will step. Valenzuela throws a knuckleball again to Socia when he wants a new ball. Socia, 91 attempted steals against him this year, has thrown out 29. So almost 8 of 10 who tried have been successful.
He threw a lob curve that time. He didn't know what to do.
Seven times in his career, Cesar Cedeño has stolen 40 or more bases. He's 12 of 19 this season. One ball, one strike, one out. No score in the game. Top of the fifth. Pitch out. Now, Art Howe, the hitter, may have Valenzuela and Socia in the box. Two ball, one strike with one out. Socia looking in to Danny Ozark, who calls the pitch outs for Socia and for manager Tom Lasorda. We'll have to make a decision.
Boy, it'll be a big one. It'd be a very luxurious pitch out if he does. I wouldn't think he would, Tony. He's going to have to try to hold him on and give Socia a chance to throw him out. That would really be asking a lot to pitch out now.
You can see the slow, methodical delivery to home plate by Valenzuela. It gives that base dealer a couple of... He's gone. He's got a pick down. Garvey will go to Russell. The dive. He's out. Pickoff number 5 on the air for Fernando Valenzuela. And Cedeño is hurt and down at second base on the dive. Don Tiger is out. He pulled a hamstring, Joe. On the dive, he pulled something, which would really be a big loss for this Astros team. You might recall it happened last year when Cedeño dislocated his ankle stepping on first base trying to beat out a ball. An extreme pain, and I would think, and we're not going to assume anything at this point, but it will really hurt the Astros.
Getting up very slowly.
Don Leppert under his left arm. Don Kiger, the trainer. Lillis out, Burden out. In fact, the concern even on the faces of Lopes and the Dodgers.
He broke
mighty, mighty early, and he's picked off by a big margin. I couldn't really tell where he pulled anything.
What a severe blow to the Astros, because it was Cedeño who had such a good day against Valenzuela in game one. From our left center field camera, we'll see if we can pick up the injury. Hit very hard, very hard.
When he landed, it looked like when he landed, he's running as well as he ever, right here. It looks like where he hurt it, right there.
Second base umpire Ed Montague. He tried to guess, Cedeño did, on Valenzuela. He missed. 2-1 pitch, a screwball. Now how count goes 2-2 with two outs.
Valenzuela was just a little more patient than Cedeño.
It's one base hit in this ball game. Cedeño single. He's caught stealing on the pickoff. Screwball chopped to Guerrero. Guerrero to Garvey. So after the single and pickoff, Howe goes down. We'll go to the bottom of the fifth here in Dodger Stadium. Garvey, Monday, and Guerrero will come up to face Fern Rule, who is still pitching a no-hitter. Your score, nothing, nothing. Cesar Cedeño in obvious pain, carried into the locker room by his teammates J.R. Richards and Joe Pittman. Remember that Cedeño in game number one against Valenzuela, single, stole second base, double, stole third base. His replacement will be Dennis Walling, who got the big pinch hit in game number two to win it in the Astrodome.
Steve Garvey.
Fern Rule has retired 12 consecutive Dodgers. Still riding a no-hitter. Garvey grounded out to short in the second. In four innings, Rule has made just 31 pitches. Garvey, who excited this crowd, the first inning yesterday with a two-run home run. Ball one. Pujols turned on the home plate umpire, McSherry, thinking the ball at the outside corner. Full house in Dodger Stadium. Fouled off by Garvey. He was right on a breaking ball, just fouled it back. 1-1.
You see by the swing, Garvey didn't appear to be fooled by it at all. He had a good cut.
9 of the 12 hitters that Rule has faced have grounded out in the infield. No score, bottom of the fifth. 1-1 to count on Steve Garvey. Fly ball, left center field, Jose Cruz. He's got it, one out. 13 in a row for Fern Rule.
Monday.
You can see Cruz, that sign above his head. Be careful that you don't lose the ball. He was signaling to the other outfielders, let's help each other out. Now it's Monday.
You always keep in mind what the hitter did the last time up. Monday hit the first pitch hard to left field. Remember, Cruz made a good running catch.
Rule and Valenzuela pretty much had this game in their pockets, been ahead of these hitters thus far. Rule working with his normal rest. Valenzuela one day short of normal rest.
That's exactly
one strike.
That's exactly what you're thinking about, because if he hits the first pitch the last time up, you assume he's going to hit the first pitch this time up, which dictates not only what you're going to call, but where. Monday appeared to have a good cut, but that ball was in on his handles. I don't think he could have driven it too far.
Rule is not the kind of pitcher, under any circumstance, can just say, here, down the middle, hit it. he works the corners very well. He changes speeds very well. He gives his defense a chance. One strike, count on Monday with one out. 1-1, rule questions that call. Tom Lasorda, Monty Basco, the glasses, Ron Paranowski, his pitching coach, former Dodger great, and also had two good years with the Minnesota Twins in the American League. 1-1, fouled off by Monday. Burton, who started his professional career in the Yankee organization, had a sensational career with the Pirates, one of the steadiest, best defensive outfielders around, spent some time with the Cardinals. Managed the Pirates, managed the Yankees. One ball, two strikes with one out. No score in the ball game. Vern Rule still working on a no-hitter in the bottom of the fifth with one out. Fouled off again.
The thing you like about this Rule is that he has a definite idea of what he wants to do, what he wants to throw, and where. I've said it once, I said a million times, you can only suggest as a catcher, but you need somebody out there who knows what they're doing, and they're just in sync. And he is really in control.
One ball, two strikes. Misses with a breaking ball, 2-2. He obviously does not have the statistics of a catfish hunter who will someday go in baseball's Hall of Fame. The on-deck hitter is Pedro Guerrero for the Dodgers. But a similar style. The slider on the corner, sink the fastball, change speeds on it, throw you a curveball now and again, move you off the plate. Toys with the black edge as a home plate. Makes that plate look like it's 25 inches wide. Another breaking ball, a hard breaking ball, or a cut fastball. Runs the count 3-2. Rule tried to put a little extra. See that follow through to show how much effort he put on it. Three balls, two strikes, one out. Bottom of the fifth, no score. Rule versus Rick Monday, and the crowd's getting in the game. Monday takes a fastball right at the knees. So Rule has retired 14 in a row.
Pedro Guerrero.
First strikeout for Rule.
Tony, they've just given an injury report. Cedeno has a pulled muscle.
And the severity of that kind of injury can run from a severe tear to a slight pull. And they want to get ice on it in a hurry, and that's what they're doing right now. Prevent this run. Look out! Guerrero hits a very hard one of those Dodgers. So the no-hitter and the shutout go with one swing of the bat by the young Dominican Republic third baseman, Pedro Guerrero.
And Tony, if there was one guy you were going to pick, it would be him because he's been flirting all series. He hit the ball hard. If you remember in the Astrodome, he got nothing but just long outs.
Well, he thinks he might have had three home runs here, but they were hitting the dome. Now it's Socha. Trying to butt his way on, was thrown out, broken back. Walling to Rule. So the side goes down, but after five on Pedro Guerrero's home run, which excites the crowd one more day as Garvey did yesterday, the Dodgers take the lead 1-0. Valenzuela will take the mound for the sixth. A full house cheering for Guerrero. That was only the second run the Dodgers have scored for Fernando Valenzuela during his last 20 innings of work. Another run was Garvey's home run. First game of the championship series, playoffs, mini playoffs. Dickie Thont, Luis Pujols, Vern Rule to face Valenzuela. He allowed a single to Cedeño, picked him off. Cedeño injured his thigh, left the ball game. Thont fouled out in the third. Dodgers won, Astros nothing. Each team with one base hit. Screwball from Valenzuela, 1-1. Two balls and one strike. Thon can run. Guerrero at third base, playing even with a bag. Should Dickie Thon try to bunt the ball? Valenzuela goes three balls and one strike. Valenzuela, nicknamed the Bull, as we look at Pujols on deck. 3-1. Dickie Thon is on with nobody out. And Burden will give him the green light. He loves to run. In fact, Burden says Dickie Thon gets a little reckless. He likes to run so much. Got to hold him down at time and put the don't steal sign on. So Luis Pujols will come up with Thon at first.
That pickoff play by Valenzuela will be in Dickie Thon's mind and also Verdon's. Could be the play, a hit and run here to stay away from the double play.
First base on balls in the ball game. It's given up by Valenzuela. Pujols grounded to third, his only other at bat this game. Thon with a pretty decent lead, but see which way he's leaning. Whenever Fernando pitches, the Spanish American speaking population comes out in force. Becomes somewhat of a national hero. Screwball has Pujols way out in front. Landro fairly deep to left center field, one out. Ball just kept carrying. We missed yesterday's ball game. We talked about the difference in this park from the Koufax Drysdale era. This used to be an excellent pitcher's ballpark. Then, late 60s, they took home plate and moved it 10 feet closer to the outfield fences. So now those gaps at 370, 385, and right and left center field are more reachable. Shorter by 10 feet down the lines. See panoramic view of this ballpark. One out, look out for Thon at first. Popped up on the grass. Valenzuela will go to Lopes. So Rule, with a sacrifice, pushes Thon to second base.
Carrying full right field.
They talk not only of Valenzuela's composure on the mound, but of the kind of fielder he is. We have seen him this year, a little bit of a mix-up one time in Cincinnati. But he covers and fields his position very well. He knows which base to throw, and I think that's the kind of experience he's had. When you sign a professional contract at the age of 15, and all your brothers and sisters play, you're going to pick up a little bit. Two outs. Dodgers one, Astros nothing. Top of the sixth. Terry Poole. One ball. Poole is grounded out and fly to center field. Dickie Thon with excellent speed in the lower right-hand corner of your screen. He carries the tying run.
He gave up the first base on balls in this inning to Dickie Thon, and now he's two balls and no strikes. And you remember we made a point earlier that he was ahead of everybody starting out with strikes. In fact, we even facetiously said something about when it was ball one, it would be like he was behind him. So it may be a tip-off to the pitching coach falling behind these hitters.
Terry Poole has pushed Valenzuela to a two-ball, no-strike count. He got a breaking ball on 2-0, hit it on the end of the bat, Monday in right center field. Valenzuela strands Dickie Pound at second base. First man left on base in this ball game will go to the bottom of the sixth here in Dodger Town with a score. Dodgers 1, Astros nothing. Russell, Valenzuela, and Lopes scheduled for the Dodgers. Dodgers lead 1-0 over the Astros going into the bottom of the sixth. Byrne Rule has been all but perfect except for Pedro Guerrero with his home run in the fifth. Bill Russell fly to left field to third. Could be trouble, hit off the fist. Scott comes in, it bounds in front of him. So Russell's on, and Valenzuela up. Bill Russell jumped on an inside breaking pitch, high in the strike zone. He'll set up a sacrifice situation for Fernando Valenzuela.
Valenzuela got his instructions from the bench, although, like all pretty good ball players, he gave Danny Ozark a chance to flash some signs. The Astros having all kinds of meetings. Dickie Thon went out to Rule, and they set up as to who will be covering. Walling came in from first base to find out what's going on, and Pujols became an interesting bystander.
I will see the movement on this infield for the Astros. In what looks like a sure bunt situation for Valenzuela. Rule may try and ride a fastball high, try and get Valenzuela to pop it up. Russell's at first. Dodgers 1, Astros nothing. Howe way in at third base. Place to go would be to Walling at first. He's got to hold Russell close. Walling, the replacement for Cedeno, and he injured his leg. Popped up. Pujols will not get on the fly. Russell with an excellent jump off first base for Fernando. It's a big hand for a good sacrifice. Good piece of base running, Joe, by Bill Russell, because Pujols had that ball in a hurry.
And he had some ideas of going to second base, but the jump that Russell had off first base. Now watch when Pujols picks it up. Now Russell, as soon as he sees that ball hit, he's gone, digging hard.
What Russell was doing was he was watching not the pitcher Rule, he was watching the first baseman. The farther off the bag that Walling got charging the hitter, the farther off Russell got. So now, in this 1-0 ball game, the Dodgers leading. They've got another threat going with Russell on second base and Davey Lopes the hitter. He has grounded out twice. Giving Russell a lot of room. Bottom of your screen at second base. One ball. Look out. Much more vocal crowd than yesterday's. Garner jockeying back and forth to try and hold Russell closer. Fouled off by Lopes, 1-1 with one out. The only run in the ball game. Young man from the Dominican Republic, Pedro Guerrero. Called to play third base for the injured Ron Say. Say's been taking batting practice and swinging the bat better every day. Should the Dodgers win, Say would be able to come back for the league championship series. But that's still a ways off. The Dodgers have to win today and tomorrow. One ball, one strike, one out. Russell's at second. Rule will pitch to Lopes. This is high. high with a breaking ball, 2-1. On deck for the Dodgers, Ken Landreau. Rule misses low again, it's 3-1.
Got first base open, but you doubt as Verdon looks on that he's trying to make him hit a particular pitch, because he's going right into the heart of the lineup if he loses Davey Lopes.
Well, the chances of doubling a left-handed hitter up like Landreau, the following hitter, are not too good. There's Russell at second. He misses. Lopes is out. Runners on first and second for the Dodgers with one out. Two walks in the ball game. Each pitcher has allowed one. Landreau has grounded to second base twice in this ball game. He was in a severe second half slump. Then right near the end of the season, he got a little hotter, had some base hits. But he's one of these guys at Moda, their hitting instructors, try to convince that he is not a pull hitter. He's tried to pull rule twice and hit the ground balls to second. Last 37 ball games that Landreau has played, he's had just 4 runs batted in. Popped up in the infield, will be no infield fly, it is not high enough. Dickie Thon has it. Judgment of the third base umpire, Jerry Dale. Ball was not high enough for the infield fly rule, but there are 2 outs. Bring up another tough hitter for Vern Rule and Dusty Baker. Baker is grounded out and lined hard to center field. Conference on the mound now with the Astros in middle infielders. How are you going to play Baker? You're going to stick with the same pitching pattern with men on base? You're going to pitch him inside. We'll play him a little more to pull on the left side. You're going to pitch him away. We'll play him up the middle. Dodgers 1, Astros nothing, but the Dodgers are threatened. Dickie Thon and Garner, shortstop at second base, are playing very deep. Knock a ball down, so Russell cannot score. Tough hop. Howe will go. He just came down in time. Throw to Garner with Lopes with an excellent jump. Garner landed on the bag. Second base umpire Ed Montague said, beat him just in time, Joe.
And Garner, very wisely, after Howe got the tough hop on top of the bag, he knew where he was going to come down.
That is close.
Very close.
That is close.
Lopes
is signaling safe right there. So after 6 here in Dodgers Stadium, Dodgers 1, Astros nothing. We'll be back after these messages from your local station.
Bill Garner, second base.
Joe Garagiola with Tony Kubek here at Dodgers Stadium, where we've got a dandy going. Right now, 1-0. The Dodgers are leading 1 run, only 2 hits. One of those 2 hits, a home run by Guerrero. No errors. Astros, no runs. 1 hit, no errors. That hit was by Cedeño in the 5th, and he pulled a muscle after being picked off at first base. Garner leads it off. He struck out in the 1st. He popped a 3rd in the 4th. Valenzuela against Rule. The kind of a game you would expect these two teams to be playing, as they've done it throughout this series. Right field, Monday is there. 1 out. Brings up Tony Scott, who struck out in the 1st. Struck out in the 4th. And if I were catching right now, I'd say watch for the bunt. He may try to beat one out.
pitching with 3 days rest, which Valenzuela was very successful at, as Tommy Lasorda told us, six times this season. But if he's going to tire, you should start looking for it. That last ball was up high, Joe, that Garner jumped all over.
Ball one on Scott. Valenzuela has struck out four. Struck out two in the first, one in the third, one in the fourth. He has walked one man. He's behind again. Two balls and no strikes.
He's behind, and the pitches he's thrown have been up in the strike zone.
And that's the danger zone. Ball three, breaking ball, 3-0.
Just before the strike, when Valenzuela began to struggle a little bit, he got a little tired from all the media pressures, pitching with 3 days rest, and he lost the feel on the screwball, so he sat on the fastball.
Three balls and a strike to count. Tony Scott, the batter, takes a look at his third base coach, Leppard. Astros have only had two base runners. Cedeno was picked off and Dickie Thon, who walked. Straight away center field. Landro should have no problem. Two outs. It brings up Jose Cruz, who lined hard to left and fouled out to the catcher. He's 0 for 2.
Joe, and I know, like all baseball fans around the country, we've been seeing a lot of baseball when we've been able to, and on both networks, really, in all the four divisional championship. I've had a chance at times to watch Enberg and Seaver, and I want to congratulate them on the fine job they're doing. Very informative, Enberg. Very analytical, Tom Seaver. It's been fun. I've learned a lot.
Strike one. We've had some dandy games. Foul back. That got old John McSherry. He'll take that mask off and check it.
Once again, it's a pitch up in the strike zone that Cruz has timed fairly well. He did not jerk his head. Boy, that'll jolt you.
Oh. You ever want to get the feeling of what that's like? Get an old bell, put your head in, and hit it with the ball peen hammer. That sucker will ring for 10 minutes.
Oh.
One ball, two strikes, two outs. 1-0. We are in the seventh inning, Valenzuela, for the Dodgers, rule for Houston. Missed. He's nibbling. Two balls and two strikes.
Well, you take Cedeno out of that lineup, you don't have a whole lot of hitters in that Astros lineup to get the ball out of the ballpark on you. Art Howe did yesterday. He's got to get a pitch right in his wheelhouse, though.
Bouncing ball. Davey Lopes is over there. In time. Another perfect inning for Valenzuela. It's three up, three down. We go to the bottom of the seventh. Dodgers 1, Astros nothing. And it'll be Garvey, Monday, and Guerrero for Los Angeles. NFL football tomorrow begins with NFL 81 with Brian Gumbel. The highlights, the scores, all the late breaking news, and then we'll have regional NFL action. Check your local listings. We'll be featuring the Browns against the Steelers. What a rivalry that is. Raiders meet the Chiefs in Kansas City, and that'll be followed by the Phillies and the Expos, who the Phillies won today. So on Vukovic's home run, they're tied two games apiece. And the Dodgers, if they should win, will be on too. So check your local listings for the game and time in your area. It begins with NFL 81. Here is Garvey. Garvey is 0 for 2. Strike one. The attendance today, as you saw, 55,983. Largest non-World Series crowd in the history of Dodger Stadium. Last night they had 46,820 paid, a difference of 9,163. And there's the average attendance in the 1981 Division Series. And that doesn't include tonight, so that'll go up a bit. One strike on Steve Garvey. Rule has made only 54 pitches. There's 55, a base hit.
Monday,
Bobby is on. It brings up Rick Monday. Walling will have to hold him close, give him a gap between first and second. What would you do? Would you be bunting?
Garvey, after rounding first, will try and turn this crowd on even further.
I think I'd be looking for a punt, Tony. Would you?
I don't think so, because, well, Howe is at third base. And he knows better than we do what's going on. He's down there on the field. But what do they do then? Do they
pitch around Guerrero?
In the alley, put him in first base. Then you'd have a right-hander against left-hander.
And the wheels are spinning. That's what baseball's all about. Nobody's always right. Nobody's always wrong.
I think Verdon will try and let Monday shoot through that gap. Garvey being held by Walling.
We'll soon see. Monday is 0 for 2. Struck out and flied out.
Trying to get Monday to commit himself with a throw over. Gave no indication at that point that he was bunting.
All kinds of strategy to think about. Squares around. He bunts beautifully. Rule will have to go to first base. He does. Garvey stops at second. And I would think that they would now walk Guerrero and pitch to Socha to set up the double play.
Well, you would think that that would go against percentages, walking a right-hander against a right-handed pitcher to get to a left-hander Socha. But the bolt that Guerrero hit in the fifth to give the Dodgers a 1-0 lead may dictate what to do.
See what they do. Managers, they have to make the decision now. I'm going to pitch to him.
Ball. Tony Scott in center field has it. Garvey tags up, starts over, and stops. So there are two outs.
Now Verdon will have to make another move. Does he walk the left-handed in Socha? Pitch to Russell.
He's going to talk to him to find out just exactly how he feels. This will be a decision that Rule will make. I think
Verdon. I don't think Verdon wavers at all. I think Verdon says either put him on or pitch to him.
Tony, it's not a question of wavering. It's how a pitcher feels. I mean, it may feel sometimes a pitcher feels, hey, I can get this guy out better than I can Russell. I mean, it's not strictly percentages. It's not a case of wavering. It's how you feel.
Russell does have a base hit off Rule, single to center field in the sixth. I know one thing. I think I'd rather pitch to the eighth hitter than the seventh hitter, who's left-handed.
Well, regardless, we'll pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC Television Network.
Go for it. WDIV Detroit.
They're going to put him on. So that settles that. That'll be the second walk given up by Rule. This one intentionally, and it'll be up to Bill Russell, who single to center field his last time up and fly to left. There's ball two. One run, three hits, no errors for the Dodgers, no runs, only one hit, no errors for the Astros.
I recall that Bill Russell got his first hit yesterday in a key situation. He has not been a slouch for these Dodgers. Overlooked many times, but he was a pretty good second place hitter. And used to get a lot of big hits to keep rallies going.
He was in an eighth inning yesterday when he drove in a run. And they scored three. After having scored three in the first, they won it 6-1. So it's Bill Russell.
He's the kind of guy who'll jump you too, and I think that's what Pujols is going to tell Rule. Make your best pitch on the first pitch.
This telecast is presented by Authority of Major League Baseball. It's intended solely for the private, non-commercial use of our audience, and any publication, reproduction, retransmission, or the use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this game without the express written consent of Major League Baseball is prohibited. Two outs. Base runners are at first and second. Socha is at first. Garvey is at second. Russell, the batter, 1-0. Dodgers at the bottom of the seventh. strike one.
Vern Rule in a battle with the Dodgers and Valenzuela as we look at Garvey and Socia on second and on first.
Right center field, it's going to drop. Base hit, one run will score. Heading for third is Socia. They got a chance. They got him. But the run scores. The run counts. Garvey got across the plate before Socia was out. So it's 2-0 Dodgers. The inning is over.
Ozak is giving Socia right there a lecture. Son, never make the first out or the third out of an inning at third base. And it might have cost us a run if not for the hustle of Garvey. Good throw by Terry Poole. Here he comes again, going to his right, gets rid of it in a hurry and very accurately.
So at the end of seven innings, the Dodgers pick up another run. The score here, Los Angeles 2, Houston nothing.
Here's the second Dodger run. Look at John McSherry, the home plate umpire. He is lining Garvey up with third base to see if the tag was made at third on Socia before or after Garvey crossed home plate. When he crossed home plate and Socia tagged, he immediately made the indication the run does count. It was very brazen base running by Socia.
With his speed, very brazen. Ping Bodie's line. Larceny in his heart, lead in his feet. Ball one to Walling. Walling got that big base hit. He's one for one in this series. The pinch hitter pops this one up. Landros coming in. He says, I have it. Makes the play. Valenzuela, one out. Here in the eighth.
Third base.
Earlier games of Phillies on a home run by Vukovic, 6-5. They play tomorrow. That'll be following football. Milwaukee beat the Yankees 2-1. Game four, they play.
Pete Vukovic coming off a sick bed.
Ball game that was. We look at Ron Say. And if the Dodgers hold on here, we'll be right back here. Big day on NBC tomorrow. A lot of football, a lot of baseball, it seems like. Howell takes it outside. Ball one. Howell, two base hits in his last 19 times at bat. One of them a home run. High hopper, base hit. Howell is on. And that's his wife.
So Howe got the screwball, and with Guerrero playing just behind the bag on this hard infield, he pops it over his head.
Thon fouled out his first time up and walked in the sixth.
Now for the first time, we see some rummaging around of the Dodger bullpen. So Tom Lasorda has sent the word down his post-ball game. That is Steve Howe, the left-hander. Welch, number 35. You're not too much of a hurry at this point.
Off the end of the bat, Steve Garvey will take it himself, makes the tag, and Howell moves on down to second base. Boy, I tell you, when Garvey holds those two big arms out, they're like a toll gate coming down on you.
A little football experience in the Big Ten. He really braced himself right here in case Dickie Thon tried to have a collision with him. He had the ball in the bare hand, actually, tagging with the back of the glove, and he's pulling the ball out. An old catcher's trick that you know so well.
You get the feeling Popeye just tagged you out?
This looked like an arm and a hammer advertisement.
I'd like to tape that conversation. Valenzuela just keeps nodding, yes, yes, yes. Rooting for her husband, Louis Pujols. So there are two outs. Side.
Pujols 0 for 5 in the series. Art Howe is on at second base. Valenzuela has allowed two base hits. Bloop single by Cedeno, and a high hopper by Howe. Cedeno picked off, pulled a muscle, had to leave the game. Fouls it off. One ball and one strike.
Valenzuela has struck out just 4 in this ball game. He's had some games this year in double figures. In fact, more than a few.
One ball and one strike. Line foul. He tried to punch that ball into right field.
7 times this season. There's Rule on deck, but the chances of him hitting if Pujols gets on are almost nil. 7 times he's been hit with Sarna. His pitcher, Fernando Valenzuela, has been in double figures this year in strikeouts.
One ball, 2 strikes, 2 outs, 2-0. Dodgers leading. We're in the 8th. Valenzuela has it. Ends the inning. Bottom of the 8th. Dodgers 2, Astros nothing. And what a hand Valenzuela will get when he leads off. Fernando Valenzuela, tremendous hand from this crowd, takes a low ball one, 55,983. They do treat him like Lasorda said. Maybe he is an old Mexican general who came back.
Well, if Valenzuela can hold the lead, the Astros will look down the barrels of the left arm of Royce tomorrow.
Phil Garner backhands it, makes the play, 1 out.
And of course, the Dodgers will see Nolan Ryan, who allowed just 2 base hits in the Dome in game 1, won a home run by Garvey.
Valenzuela takes a lot of time. Davey Lopes will be coming up Saturday night here in Los Angeles, and following the local news, Saturday Night Live on NBC. The reviews on the new cast, great. They are a bit at times, they make you sit up and say, did he really say that?
Perhaps,
but that's Saturday Night Live.
Perhaps if I give producer Dick Ebersol a little pop on the air, he'll give you a hosting job for
give
that show.
Give you the
someday.
Hosting job. That'd be your kind of show. Hot smash. Art Howe backs it up. He's got it. 2 up, 2 down. Art Howe at third base.
Not the most mobile of third basemen. He's really been slowed down a lot. Let's see. Torn Achilles tendon, which will require surgery after the season. But many people felt that Howe was the most valuable player, at least the first half of the season, for this ball club, and maybe all year. He's left off the All-Star team. For many months of the season, he was leading the league in hitting.
Landros, strike 1. Now you see Ruth Ryan, Nolan Ryan's wife, and son Reed. Remember after the no-hitter, how Ruth rushed out on the field, sharing that moment. Right field. Poole is waiting. Makes the catch, so Vern Rule gives up only 4 hits but 2 runs, and we go into the 9th inning. It'll be the pitcher spot, Terry Poole and Garner, with the Dodgers leading 2-0. Fernando Valenzuela, he means many things to many people. We asked Steve Garvey what he means to the club and to the crowd.
Well, that's the great thing about Fernando. He's been the same person last year as he is now, one of the most popular people in this country in sports. But the one interesting thing is he's become more animated. Although he doesn't speak English, he has that rapport with the crowd just through facial expressions, and that's what makes him truly an enjoyable human being.
Steve Garvey talking about his teammate, Valenzuela. We have a new right fielder for the Dodgers. Rick Mundy has been replaced. And there you see Daryl Thomas. And the pinch hitter for the Houston Astros is Garcia, Kiko Garcia. Valenzuela has made 90 pitches, with that pitch included, and 66 of them have been strikes. 66 out of 90 pitches, strikes. It's popped up in the short center field. Landro should have no problem. One out. And in a tribute to Vern Rule, he made only 67 pitches, gave up only 4 hits, won a home run. Dodgers have a 2-run lead. He gave up 2 runs, 4 hits. He walked 2, struck out 1. Vern Rule, a tough pitcher. Valenzuela just a bit tougher as we look at Poole. Right center field. No one will get this one. This will be extra bases. Poole is digging hard. He'll stop at second. It's a double. So, Terry Poole is on at second base. Tying run is at the plate. Phil Garner, as we look at the bullpen, the left-hander is Howe, the right-hander, Welch. We're meeting on the mound. One man out. Should the Dodgers hold on, what a battle they'll have out here tomorrow. Ryan, Nolan Ryan, Jerry Royce, 4 o'clock. It'll all start on NBC with football, NFL 81. Regional coverage and the Expos and the Phillies and Dodgers in Houston. Should the Dodgers hold on? So check your local listings. It's a big day. A lot of excitement. Didn't get it. Waiting, one strike, one out. Two strikes, 55,983, and they'll be rooting and umpiring. Jimmy Lopes, 2 outs. Terry Poole takes third. So there are 2 outs, a man on third, and Tony Scott the batter. As Bill Burton looks on, the crowd starting to get to its feet. Listen. Talking to Peranowski, Monty Bazgall looking on. The bullpen was busy. Cruz, 10 of his 13 home runs have been on the road. He has seven of them lifetime against the Dodgers, and that's what he's thinking. One ball, one strike, two outs, 2-1. Ninth inning, tying run at first, Tony Scott. Lead run at the plate. Is bouncing around right now. And Bill Verdon, you can't tell what the score is. Three balls, one strike, two outs. Tony Scott has about a step lead. He's not about to get picked off, take the bat out of this fella's hands. The ball game that Valenzuela made. He wins the ball game 2-1. The Dodgers 2-2 now, play tomorrow. Tough luck loser, Vern Rule. You can see a very happy Valenzuela as he watches his catcher, Socha, make the play. And he was right there should that ball pop out in the mid. He's sneaking up there. It's over, and Tony Kubek is with Fernando. Let's go down to Tony.
All right, Joe, thank you so much. It is absolutely bedlam down here. The fans refuse to leave with Fernando standing here. The man right here in the pinstripe suit is Jaime Harin, Spanish-speaking broadcaster on the Dodgers Broadcasting Network. He is the personal confidant and translator for Fernando Valenzuela. Jaime, tell him for all of us, congratulations, and ask him what kind of thrill this was for him.
Dice que primero quiere felicitarte mucho y que luego qué clase de emocionante fue este juego.
Bueno, muchas gracias. Bueno, para mí, o sea, para el equipo era bastante importante porque teníamos que ganarlo. Y pues para mí fue otro juego más. O sea, yo creía que, o sea, estaba como otro juego más. Pero
well,
sabía lo
this was a
que
very
era.
Important game for the team. We know that we had to win this game. For me, it was just another game.
Is this the biggest ball game he felt he has ever pitched? He said it's only another game, but it didn't seem like it. Not as emotional as he was after the ball game.
Este, si bien fue para ti solamente cualquier otro juego, fue emocionalmente un juego especial para ti.
Bueno, sí, porque como dije, fue un juego como otro, pero yo sabía que era bastante importante para el equipo.
Yes, it was another game, but yes, I knew that it was the biggest game that we have ever had.
Jaime, thank you so much, Fernando. Congratulaciones. Buena suerte. Back up to Joe Gargiulo.
Okay. Tony Kubek with his Spanish. Okay, the Dodgers win it 2-1, and we'll be right back after these messages. Well, if you're just joining us, Bedlam here at Dodger Stadium. The Dodgers behind Valenzuela beat Houston 2-1. The series is tied at 2 apiece. Tomorrow it'll be Royce and Ryan. And if you heard the tail end of that interview, the Spanish that you heard was not from Jaime Harim, Valenzuela's interpreter. It was Tony Kubek, and it was not Saturday Night Live as we were talking about, although Tony's got a good chance to go on Saturday Night Live with that. He's down with Minnesota.
All right, thanks to you. Standing with me, a couple of men and one who just left to push this Western Division Championship Series miniseries to game number 5, where it'll be Ryan versus Royce, Tommy Lasorda, Valenzuela, and Pedro Guerrero. What about him?
Well, I'll tell you, Tony, I can't tell you how happy I am. We came back from Houston. We were really down 2-0. But the guys really had a lot of desire and a lot of enthusiasm, and they were really confident that they could come back here in our park. Thank God we're able to go into that 5th game. I'm so happy tonight.
Pedro, I want to know the feeling. I guess it'd be a cliche to say it is the biggest home run of your career, but the crowd cheers and your reaction to it.
Well, let me tell you, you know, I got to feel happy about it because, like I said, in Houston, I hit 2 balls, but there was a lot of different than playing here. We played here, now we're at home, and when I hear that crowd, you know, doing that kind of noise for the team, I got to feel happy. I feel excited about it because I know that we're at home, and there's no question about it. We're going to beat him. I said we're going to beat him, and we beat him 2 in a row, and tomorrow's a big game, so I
Pete,
hope we do
it. I thank you so much. Congratulations. Tommy, our thanks to you. We've got to go. We'll see you out here tomorrow. Joe?
Okay, 2-1 the final score. Tomorrow it's Royce against Ryan. And NBC's National League Division Series has been brought to you by Ford and your Ford dealer, who invites you to test drive the 1982 Ford cars and trucks. By the Miller Brewing Company, brewers of Miller High Life. If you've got the time, we've got the beer. And by Head & Shoulders regular and conditioning formula for extra manageability. And by Zena System 3, the quality goes in before the name goes on. The executive producer of NBC Sports is Don Oldmeyer. The coordinating producer of NBC's Baseball and the producer of tonight's game, Michael Weissman. Directed by Harry Coyle. Technical director, Ray Figelski. Associate director, John J. Filippelli. Associate producer, David Neal. Tomorrow, a full day of sports on NBC, leading off with week number 6 of the NFL season. Regional coverage, including Cleveland versus Pittsburgh, Oakland to Kansas City. Starts with NFL 81, so check your local listings for the game and time in your area. And then it's game 5 in the West, the Astros and the Dodgers. In the East, it's the Phillies and the Expos live at 4 o'clock Eastern time. All right here on NBC, the leader in innovative sports television. Now, most of you will see the Stalker starring Terry Bradshaw, followed by local news and Saturday Night Live.